In my last deliberation, I spoke about Siddhartha Gautam, who was born as a prince and subsequently renounced the world comfort to set out in search of peace and freedom from all the sufferings of the world, all the sufferings of the life. In order to understand life and teachings of Buddha, a broader political and conceptual context, we must understand the socio-economic condition of India prior to Buddha. In the 3rd millennium BC, there existed a highly developed culture, a civilization in India and Indian subcontinent. This civilization, like any other civilization of the ancient world, started in the river valleys, like in Egypt, Mesopotamia, China, and India simultaneously. These are contemporary civilizations, and Indus Valley civilization was described as, along with all the civilizations of the world, these are described as the cradle of civilization, and it can be described that this kind of civilization was highly developed and it existed from 3000 to 1500 BC in India. The excavations carried out in the Indus Valley, mostly in Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, now in present-day Pakistan, it reveals that it was highly developed and a urban civilization. Except the use of iron, they had the knowledge of bronze, they had the knowledge of alloy metals, and they have domestication of animals, they were having agricultures, and even the ports to carry out their trade and commerce activities beyond that particular geographical area. And this civilization had a script also, but unfortunately, we have not yet been able to describe or decipher the scripts which could have told us a lot many things about the conditions of India during 3000 BC to 1500 BC. Now this flourished quite some time for 1000 years before it came to an end. And the reason for the end of the civilization is ascribed to many reasons, and one of them is the coming of some alien people known as the Aryans to this part of the country, this part of the world, and they had a fighting with the Indus Valley people, and subsequently the civilization ended. But this is just one theory. There are other theories about that, about the destruction of that Indus Valley civilization, which is highly developed. And perhaps it tells us about its contribution to the composite Indian culture, which we see today. And also, some scholars believe that this was the basis of early Buddhism in India. From amongst various artifacts discovered from Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, we find a lot of seals in which we find some traces of Buddhism as some people or some scholars ascribe to it. There are figures of human beings sitting in a yogic posture in a meditation way, and people say, the scholars who believe that it has something to do with Buddhism, they think that this meditation was perhaps the one exactly like what Buddha took after several years. Then we have the picture of in the seal we have a depiction of a tree which is told as Bodhi tree, which in subsequent part of my lecture I will be describing about the Bodhi tree. So Bodhi tree is also very sacred to Buddhism. Now Indus Valley civilization came to an end, as I told you, from 1800 to 1500 BC. And the reason, there are many reasons were given, and one of the reasons is given by the coming of the Aryans. Now the question comes, who are the Aryans? There are no two opinions about the Aryans coming from outside India, but no two scholars agree on the homeland of the Aryans. But what has been believed till now, that Aryans are a group of Indo-European people who migrated from the Russian steppe and from the Caspian Sea area. And these people, they came to India from Central Asia and North frontier Indian territories, that is from Afghanistan, Iran, they come from that direction, and they settled down in Gangetic Plain, in the Gangetic River Basin. And some scholars ascribe that Aryan civilization is an extension of the Indus Valley civilization, which was already there, which is very developed. Now, what is this Aryans they had to do with the history of India? The Aryans also came down in different batches, and they had settled down in different places of Indus, of Gangetic Basin. Now, when these Aryans were coming in different groups, these are different groups of people. Those who are coming, they were under the constant fighting for one another to have a piece of land for themselves to establish their kingdoms. And that perhaps gave birth to the four divisions of the society during that time. What are the four divisions? Because when the Aryans, they are fighting with each other in order to get some piece of land for themselves to settle down, so everybody has to fight. Now, if everybody will be fighting, then who will be cultivating the land? Who will be giving the food? If everybody will be fighting, then who will look after the people of that particular clan or particular tribe? So they divided the system, they divided the society into four groups. Those who will be fighting, they are the warrior class, or they are known as Kshatriyas. Then, in order to win the war, they need to pray to the god. And if the god wishes, they can win the war. That is why a group of people were there who will look after the worship or offering to the god and talking to the god so that God can bless them to win the war. So they were the priestly class who was supposed to be the communicator between the man and the god, and they will pray the god and God will give them victory. Then one class is Brahman, who is worshipping the god. Then came the Kshatriyas, those who will be fighting. Now those who will be supplying food and those who will be cultivating the land, they were known as Vaishyas, those who will be doing supplying the materials or the food to other place people, they were known as Vaishyas. And then came the Shudras, those who will be looking after and serving all the three classes, they were known as Shudras. So the society was divided into four different sections according to their own work. Somebody is to fight, somebody is to worship, somebody is to give food, somebody is to serve everybody. So these are four sections of the society. Now, during this time, these people, the Aryans, as I said, they settled down in Gangetic Plains. During that time, they established their small kingdoms and small dominions where they will be having their sway. And by 6th century BC, India was divided into number of territories known as Mahajanapadas. Maha means the great, Janapada is the kingdom. So the great kingdoms, there were 16 great kingdoms in 6th century BC around the time of Buddha. Now in this 6th century BC, the Mahajanapadas, they are known as Anga, Magadha, Kasi, Kosala, Bajji, Malla, Cheti, then Bansa, Kuru, Panchala, then there are many others like Machya, Surasena, Ashok, Abanti, Gandhara, Kamboja. So there are 16 Mahajanapadas. From among the 16 Mahajanapadas, a ruler was ruling in some places. These were republics. A group of people were ruling over there. Now, in subsequent times, we find only three Janapadas became very popular and very powerful in course of time. And one of the most important Mahajanapada was Magadha, whose king was Bimbisara. it was the time of just before Buddha. That was the situation, a political situation in India.